What?
Is not this amazing? But how does it work? Let us explain you. We are a group of students from the French engineering school FELMA. We are working on that phenomenon, and in this video we are going to explain it to you. First, you may think that it's caused by the weight of the falling part of the chain and the rigidity of this one, which will create an upward force that will explain why there is a fountain.
Wrong!
You can see here that the chain can be more curved, so it can be the rigidity.
In fact, it's different. The phenomenon is caused by the resultant of force from the holder, which pushes the chain upwardly. Now the chain is subjected to two forces on its base, the tension of the upward part of the chain, tension caused by the weight, and the reaction of the holder. Now let's try to write some equations. So here is our first hypothesis. The two forces are proportional to the speed, with two coefficients, alpha and beta. Keep the alpha in mind. Now, if we apply the second Newton's law of motion to a little part of the chain, we have this equation. Considering this equation, the previous forces and the centripetal acceleration, we finally have this equation.
Our objective was to verify that the ratio is constant and also coherent with the geometry. So we left several chains fall from different heights, H1, and collected data. We used two 20 meters long chains, one with small beds and the other one with bigger beds. We also used the glass, the chain container, with a lower diameter to see the impact it can have on the fountain. Moreover, we did some experiences with the two chains linked together. Here are the data we collected. The graph represents the average height of the fountain for several falling heights H1. As you can see, the global tendency is the same for each curve, and the slope of the low falling heights is quite the same for every experience. It just changes the order at the origin. This slope gives us the possibility to find an experimental alpha of 0.10. Thus, we cannot exclude the hypothesis that this alpha coefficient is not dependent of the beds, the length of the chain, or the diameter of the chain container. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions, please ask in comments.